Welcome to our Weekend of Hope Interfaith Candlelight Service 2020. My name is Will Voss, and I'm the pastor of Stowe Community Church. Obviously, our gathering tonight is different than in previous years. Obviously, we aren't meeting in our sanctuary, though if you are missing that opportunity, you may have seen in your program for this weekend that our church is hosting daily prayer services at 9:30 and 4:30. You can access those any day at stowechurch.org. But I'm so glad that it was decided for us to meet this way. We may not be able to hug one another or even be together in any physical way, but distance is no boundary to the Spirit. Let's pray together. Dear God, we call you by many names. Hear us now as we each call on you in the silence of our hearts, in the way that makes sense to us. Oh God, you know that we are going through a time of pain right now. We are all experiencing the pain of separation, of isolation. Some of us are experiencing the pain of illness. Many are experiencing the pain of fear. We ask for your healing for each one of us in the ways that we need it. We ask you to meet with us in each of our homes or wherever we are right now. Help us during this time to listen well to you and to one another. Amen. And now I'd like to introduce Rabbi David Feinsilber from the Jewish community of Greater Stowe, who is going to offer a musical welcome.
Shalom. Welcome, everyone. Sweet to be here despite our distance. Let's sing together. Sometimes in our lives we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call me when you need a friend. You just call.
Thank you, Rabbi David. I'm so glad to have you as my friend. And we've got a lot of good people with us tonight to lean on together. And the next people up are Father John and Father Joseph from Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church. They're going to lead us in a reading.
Can you guys all hear me?
We can hear you.
All right, great, cool. Wonderful, well, praise God. And so great to be with you, Rabbi. That was awesome. Thanks for kicking us off with that. It was kind of grooving with you and just a great way to set the tone for tonight that we really do need each other and what a blessing and gift each other are. So thank you for that. I wanted to share with you Psalm 21, just a 121, just a powerful psalm, just a way for us to bring ourselves into the presence of God and place his words upon our lips and upon our hearts. I raise my eyes towards the mountains. From whence shall come my help? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to slip, or your guardian to sleep. Behold, the guardian of Israel never slumbers nor sleeps. The Lord is your guardian, the Lord is your shade at your right hand. By day, the sun will not strike you, nor the moon by night. The Lord will guard you from all evil. He will guard your soul. The Lord will guard your coming and going, both now and forever. Amen.
Thank you for that wonderful and encouraging reading. We call around these parts, we call that the Vermonter's Psalm, because we lift up our eyes to the hills, the beautiful hills that God has made all around us. Well, next up we have Deb Clark from St. John's in the Mountains Episcopal Church and a key person for the Stowe Weekend of Hope. And I'm glad to have Deb as my friend as well. She's going to lead us in a song we have come to know well in our interfaith candlelight service, Bless the Lord, My Soul.
Please join me at home in singing. Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, who leads me into light. Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, who leads me into life. Bless the Lord, my soul, and bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, who leads me into life.
Thank you so much for leading us in that beautiful music. And as many of you know, this event is sponsored year after year by our Greater Stowe Interfaith Coalition. And I think one of the newest members of our coalition is Jack Wool from the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship in Stowe. And now he's going to offer a reading.
Good evening. This is Hope by Emily Dickinson. Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without words and never stops at all. And sweetness in the gale is heard, and sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird that kept so many warm. I've heard it in the chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity it asked a crumb of me.
Thank you, Jack. That's beautiful. Every year we take time in this service to lift up the names, both of those who need healing and those loved ones whom we've lost, whom we're separated from for a season in this life. So now to lead this time of naming these names of remembrance and lifting up names for healing, we have Patty Rubin from the Jewish community of Greater Stowe. And Patty is our newest president, leader, fearless leader of the Greater Stowe Interfaith Coalition.
Good evening. It is at this time in our virtual service that we invite you to light a candle in your presence before the reading of the names of remembrance. Also, if you would like to add a name, please enter it in the Zoom chat box. Reverend Will Voss will read those names. We begin in memory of Sandy Devine, Christine Mara, Gail Bourne, Cindy Lestage, Rebecca Fulliott, Elise Braun, Mary Mansfield, Jarsova Wolf, Suzanne Heller, Rose Peluso, Diane Caruso, Connie Killiani, Marsha Anderson, Terry Nichols, Anthony Muolo Sr., Ed Semches, Michelle Altadana, Larry Altadana Sr., Faith Sising, Morgan Wing Jr., Mary Leah Wool Sussman, Mary Leah Wool Leader, Calvin Potter, Hope Ann Lacey, Katie Foster, Mary Jane Phyllis Irish, Harry Fainsilber, Marvin Gamaraff, Ken Strong, Karen Newsom, Jane Landy, Jake Burton Carpenter, Joan Bunny Libby, Seth Goodhue, Eric Sunderland, Peggy Morgan, James Conley, Maddie Bordeaux, Alice Baker, Karen Donahue, Rodney William, Victor Giard, Nick Woodbury, Kenneth Bevins, Gregory Levine, Andy Homan, Alicia Sunate, Chris Chaput, Marlene Basha, Larry Michaels, Donna Dunn, Gary Greenwood, Louise Hakey, Chase Langdon, Earl Southmid, David Myers, Thomas Abiati, Lawrence Martin Eisler, Larry Jacques Eisler, Ronald Paul Eisler, Vivian and Jacques Eisler. In honor of sisters and the Stowe Weekend of Hope sisters, Valerie Van Eisler, Donna Muolo, Karen McGonigal, Yvonne Ben-Haman, and Stowe Weekend of Hope. Reverend Voss.
Thank you, Patty. Now we're going to lift up the names that have been shared with us in the chat room, and we have quite a few names here. So you still have time to add a name if you wish, either the name of someone you would like prayer for healing, or a name you would like to lift up as a name of remembrance. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you that you know the needs of each of these people represented by these names. You know how precious each one is, not only to yourself, but to each one of us. You know the names of those who have passed into your direct presence and the names of those who are in need of physical healing in this life. And so we lift up these people, we lift up their names, trusting you to meet each need according to your riches and glory. Dear God, we lift up to you Melody Izzo Bescher, Aline Girton, Richard Johnson, Josie Izzo, Adam Kirikoff, Gary Jacobson, Jack Heslin, Harry Fainsilver, Ruben Zier, Libby Cohen, Susan Bennett, James Vail Sr., Kathleen Easdale, Mac Izzo, James Vail Jr., Ava Slepikoff, Ciro Palumbo, Pamela Lazari, Richard Dana Drake, Tommy Letizer, Rita Vail, Deb Fowler Claire, Jenny Hermens, Vivi Suarez, Phyllis Broadley, Don Adams, Jean Adams, Eric Adams, Jane Dickerman, Liz Weiss, Charles Kiefer, Jeanette Hull, Rabbi Sherry Berger, Robert Laverdier, Larry Hall, Pamela Green, Alicia Boisclair, Tom Zara, Mary DeMarkey Gapser, Rita Souza, Frank Gasper, Michael Knight, Mary Costa, Pamela Broadlieb, Michelle Carter, Catherine Osello Goyette, Rhonda Rosenberg, Betty Eklund, Diana Tennant, Father Robert Yatesy, Claudia Miller, Nancy Hawthorne, David McGoldrick, Florence Golub, Barbara Wool, Mary Leader, Marta Colburn, Regina Hugo, Dave Clay, Reuben Wool, Armand Girton, Nancy Drake Simpson, Reuben Wool, Madeline and Edward Alaco, Jamie Ann Colangelo, and Laura Sphere. Father, we thank you that You hear our needs before we even ask. And so we lift up to you all of the unspoken requests represented by all of us gathering virtually tonight. And we ask not only for your physical healing where it's needed, but for spiritual healing as well, for comfort, for peace, to be filled with your love. We thank you in your name. Amen. And now we have a duo who are going to lead us in the prayers of the people, vocalizing for us both the prayers and our response. Len Randolph is from the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship in Stowe, and Lynn Altadonna from Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church.
Waiting for them to come over.
Yeah, I'm so glad he found his dad. Yeah, I'm up on the roof here.
Oh. We offer these prayers to the God of many names, some spoken. And some silent, as we wade the waters of life. In prayer, we bear our souls to God, asking for help, pleading for health, accepting the love that never leaves us, even when we feel alone. Please join me in the end of every prayer. Come to us this night, saying,
Lynn Altadonna, are you with us?
It says I am muted by the host.
Now you're not.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Come to us this night. Can you hear that? Give me a thumbs up if you can.
Yes, we can hear you.
Thank you. Len, read the next prayer.
Oh God, God, you are the strength of the weak and the comfort of those who suffer. Hear our prayers and grant to those who are ill the power of your grace, that their sickness may be turned to health and sorrow into joy. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
O God, our refuge and strength, enfold all who live with cancer in your holy embrace, that they may rest secure under the shadow of your wings. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
Strengthen your servants, O God, to go where they have to go and bear what they have to bear, that they may be restored to wholeness with a thankful heart, come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
God of love, as we go through the trials of life, help us to realize that you are with us at all times and in all things, that we have no secrets from you and your healing grace and enfolds us for eternity. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
O God, the source of all health, to fill our hearts with faith in love, with expectancy that we might make room for your power and gracefully accept your healing, come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
Good Lord, let your mighty calmness lift us above our fears and frustration. By your deep patience, give us tranquility and stillness of soul in you. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
Merciful God, you serve us through the hands and hearts of others. Bless these individuals that they may continue to serve you and share their gifts with all in need. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
God, you are my help and my comfort. You shelter and surround me in love so tender that I may know your presence with me now and always. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
This is another day, O Lord. Open me for what the day might bring forth. If I am to stand up, help me to stand bravely. If I am to sit still, help me to sit quietly. If I am to lie low, help me to do it patiently. Make these more than words and infuse them in your spirit of healing. Come to us this night.
The source of our healing and our hope.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Len and Lynn. And now we have a reading from Diane Williams, who is both a member of Stowe Community Church and the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Stowe.
I would like to read two poems to you. The first one was written by Laura Lynn Bellamy, and the title of it is Here. If here you have found freedom, take it with you into the world. If you have found comfort, go and share it with others. If you have dreamed dreams, help one another that they may come true. If you have known love, give some back to a bruised and hurting world. Go in peace. Our second poem was written by Wayne Arneson, and the title is Take Courage, Friends. Take courage, friends. The way is often hard. The path is never clear. The stakes are very high. Take courage, for deep down there is another truth. You are not alone. Thank you.
Thank you, Diane. And now we have a reading from James Charkalis of the Baha'i Faith.
Thank you, Reverend. I have a writing by Abdul Baha, the son of the prophet Baha'u'llah. O thou who art turning thy face towards God, close thine eyes to all else and open them to the realm of the all glorious. Ask whatsoever thou wishest of him alone. Seek whatsoever thou seekest from him alone. With a look he granteth 100,000 hopes. With a glance he healeth 100,000 incurable ills. With a glimpse he layeth balm on every wound. With a nod, He freeth the hearts of the shackles of grief. He doeth as he doeth, and what recourse have we? He carrieth out his will. He ordaineth what he pleaseth. Then better for thee to bow down thy head in submission and put thy trust in the all-merciful Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. And now I don't know about all of you, but I'm ready for some more music. And Rabbi David always has some good music to share. I don't know what this next piece is going to be. Oh, there we see it. But there's always a surprise in store with Rabbi David. Take it from here.
I got it. Thank you, Reverend Will. Every Saturday night, across the Jewish tradition, across the world, there's a special series of blessings that are said. And they are blessings of light, blessings over a candle, blessings over wine or grape juice, and blessings over spices, each signifying a different part. Over the last 24 plus hours, we have celebrated Shabbat. And it's a holiday that we get to come back to every week. It's a place of joy and happiness, of community and friendship in the midst of always hectic week, to come back to the purpose of our lives, the meaning and the soul. And at the end of this beautiful holiday, there's a tinge of sadness, and so we have this ritual to remind us that we bring Shabbat into the rest of our week, and we do that with a braided candle to signify the connections between this day and the rest of the week, this cup and chalice to signify the abundance of blessing in our lives, and some spices, the sweetness of Shabbat carried into the rest of the week. And before we launch into these blessings and some music, I just want to acknowledge for all of you, for all of us, just to see you, each of you, knowing that you have joined this interfaith ceremony because your lives have been touched in some way or continue to be touched through the difficulties of cancer. My own life has been touched as my father passed away 4 years ago. And so I know of the grief, and I know of this terrible disease, and some here, even with us, may be plagued with it now. And here we are in this deeply difficult moment across this world, this pandemic, and there are connections there. As we have, for those of us who have been through it with cancer, all of the grief there compounds with what we're dealing with now. And also, we have learned of the resilience, how resilient, and even how it is possible to hold on to hope in these times, despite the difficulty, to hold on to some hope, some joy. And so that is the teaching also of Havdalah, of this crossing time from Shabbat into the week, that there are difficult times, there are times to work, there are times where we are struck in ways that we wish we weren't, but there is also sweetness in life. and they are connected, they are enmeshed together, just as this beautiful candle is. So I'm going to light the candle, and I'm going to call my family to join me here, which a ritual that we do every week in our home, and which we have been sharing every Saturday night with the congregation, and so now with you all. And what a blessing to get to share it together. Give me one moment. So as my family comes in, so does the chaos. So here is a moment of joy and chaos for you all. Flame and to see the light that is within us. The light is not separate from us, and to hold up our hands and to see the light reflected into our fingernails and through our hands. that the holiness and the mundane are all deeply connected and distinguished and yet so connected. Now, before we conclude here, Hirsch, little Hirsch, will take a sip of the grape juice. And we will quietly, yes, and so will Yona. And the light will go out. But still, the light is within us. Shavua Tov, a good week to everyone. And I pass it back to Reverend Will.
Thank you, Rabbi David. That was wonderful. It reminds me of both the chaos and order that used to be in my household as well, with three boys. And it gives me great joy just seeing the little bit of community that you all have there, because we're so hungry right now for that kind of community. And some of us have families to live with, some of us live alone. And I think everybody needs to know right now that they're not really alone. Even if you live alone, God is with you, and there are people just wanting to be part of a community with you, even if we can't physically be together. We want to be there for each other, and you've wonderfully represented that for us tonight. And now Father Rick Swanson from St. John's in the Mountains Episcopal Church is going to offer our benediction.
Hello, everyone. It's gift to be with you. In this time of darkness, I offer a blessing of light and hope. Tonight, we have lit our candles that they may always burn bright in our lives. Tonight, we have lit our candles in darkness so that we may face tomorrow with hope for healing and light. Tonight, we have lit our candles in thanksgiving for life, healing, and hope to the Holy Presence beyond our understanding. Amen.
Thank you, Father Rick. And now we're going to go out together with a little bit more music from Rabbi David. If he's still there. Thank you to everyone for joining us tonight. Go in grace, go in peace. God bless.